Good evening, students. Today, 11th standard zoology chapter is called respiration, and the subtopic is called what we say mechanism of respiration or mechanism of breathing. Mechanism of breathing. We want to know first what is the definition of breathing. What is the definition of breathing? The movement of air between atmosphere and lungs is called breathing or ventilation. Please listen. The movement of air, between atmosphere and lungs is called what we going to be say. Breathing or ventilation. Kindly listen. What is called breathing? The movement of air between atmosphere and lungs is called what we say breathing or ventilation. Breathing otherwise called ventilation. So topic is what we say mechanism of breathing. Definition of breathing. The movement of air between atmosphere and lungs is called what we say breathing or ventilation. It is the 2-mark question. Kindly note it down. It is the 2-mark question. They may go to be asked, define breathing or ventilation, or what is breathing or ventilation, or what is meant by breathing or ventilation. Whatever may be the angle, they may go to be asked. Breathing contain two phases. Listen, it is the important. What are the two phases of breathing? One is called inspiration. Second one is called expiration. Please listen. Breathing contain how many phases? Two phases. First one is called what we say inspiration. Second one is called what we say expiration. See, what is inspiration and expiration we want to know. We have seen what is breathing or ventilation. What are the two phases of breathing we have seen? One is called inspiration, another one is called expiration. Inspiration means movement of atmospheric air into the lungs is called inspiration. Movement of atmospheric air into the lungs, what we are going to call inspiration. Movement of atmospheric air into the lungs is called inspiration. Simultaneously, what is called expiration? Movement of alveolar air. It is atmospheric air. It is alveolar air. Keep it on mind. Alveoli means what we say? Air sac. Air sac. What is called alveoli? Alveoli is called as what we say? Air sac. Movement of atmospheric air into the lungs is called inspiration. Movement of alveolar air diffuse out the lungs. It is in the lungs, it is out the lungs. Sir, atmospheric air into the lungs is called inspiration. Movement of alveolar air diffuse out the lungs is called expiration. See, we want to be know, breathing contain two phases, okay. First one is called inspiration, second one is called expiration. Inspiration means movement of atmospheric air into the lungs. Expiration, movement of alveolar air diffuse out the lungs. Movement of alveolar air diffuse out the lungs. It is called expiration. So these two are very important. They may going to be asked difference between inspiration and expiration. They are very important one. Atmospheric air into the lungs, inspiration. Alveolar air diffuse out the lungs is called expiration. See, I will draw a diagram The lungs diagram, for example, it is called as what we say trachea, okay. It is covered by what we say cartilage. It divides into two branches. They are called what we say. See, for example, the lung contains double walled membrane. It is contained how many walled membrane? We may say double walled membrane. See, that it leads into what we say small bronchioles. Yes. It is called what we say trachea. Okay. Trachea. It is called what we say bronchi. They are called what we say bronchioles. They are called what we say air sacs. Air sacs. The valve is called what we say pleura. So here very important, lungs do not contain muscle fiber. Lungs do not contain muscle fiber, but it is covered a membrane. The membrane is called pleura. Lungs covered by double walled membrane. What we say double walled membrane, they are called as what we say pleura. What we say pleura, very important one. Lungs do not contain muscle fibers. So keep it in your mind. I told you definition of breathing, what is called breathing or ventilation, what are the two phases of breathing, what is inspiration, what is expiration, essential point of inspiration, movement of atmospheric air into the lungs, movement of alveolar air diffuse out the lungs. Lungs do not contain muscle fiber, but lungs covered by double walled membrane is called what we say pleura. But it do not contain muscle fiber. Anyhow, lungs expand and contract by movement of ribs and diaphragm. What is ribs? We may say vela irumbugal in Tamil. Diaphragm in Tamil we may say udara vidhanam. Lungs expands and contracts by movement of ribs and what we say the diaphragm. See, if you want to know, it is the essential word, what is called diaphragm. There may be a chance. A sheet of tissue which separates thorax from abdomen. It is called thorax. It is called abdomen. It is participating what we would be called diaphragm. A sheet of tissue which separates thorax from abdomen. Lungs expands, contracts by movement of ribs and diaphragm. Diaphragm, what is called diaphragm? A sheet of tissue which separates thorax from abdomen. Thorax means what we say this. Abdomen means what with this? It is participating, dividing what we say the diaphragm. See, in relaxed diaphragm, it is a dome shaped. See here, lungs is relaxed. It is what we may say, that is called as what shaped we may say, dome shape. It is called as what we say, dome shape. Diaphragm seems to be what shape, say, dome shape. It is called as what we may say, domed or dome shape. Now listen, what are the muscles participating in breathing? Very important one. Topic is mechanism of breathing, okay. We have seen what is called breathing, what are the phases of breathing, what is called inspiration, what is called expiration. Lungs do not contain muscle fiber, and also it is covered by double walled membrane, is called what we say pleura. Lungs expand, contracts by movement of what we say ribs and what we say diaphragm. Diaphragm means a sheet of tissue which separates thorax and abdomen. Marbu, vair. Marbayum, vairayum, pirikya kudiya, thasai, udara vidhanam. In Tamil, we may say. In relaxed state, diaphragm is what you do. It may be very important one word. They may going to be asked, in relaxed state, diaphragm is what shaped, dome shape. Okay. What are the muscles participating in breathing? Very, very important point. See, 1 minute, listen. See,
our body, thorax, they are called as what we say ribs. See, one muscle, internal intercostal muscles. Internal, see the rib number one, rib number two. See, they are called as what we say internal intercostal muscle. உள் விலா எலும்பிடை தசையின் தமிழ் இன்டர்னல் இன்டர்காஸ்டல் மசில். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் எக்ஸ்டர்னல் இன்டர்காஸ்டல் மசில், வெளி விலா எலும்பிடை தசை. வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் க்வெஸ்சன், ஹவு தட் இன்ஸ்பிரேஷன் எக்ஸ்பிரேஷன் டிஃபரன்ஷியேட் வி ஹவ் சீன் த சேம் மேனர், வாட் ஆர் த மசில்ஸ் பார்ட்டிசிபேட்டிங் பிரீத்திங். ஒன் இஸ் கால்ட் இன்டர்னல் இன்டர்காஸ்டல் மசில்ஸ், செகண்ட் ஒன் எக்ஸ்டர்னல் இன்டர்காஸ்டல் மசில்ஸ். சி த ரிப்ஸ், in between the two ribs the muscles are called internal intercostal muscle, outside the muscle is called external intercostal muscle, and both found between ribs. Yeah, see, rib number 1, rib number 2, both are found between the ribs only. Both are found between, where you may say the ribs only. See, both are found between ribs. Diaphragm helps in pressure gradient. See, what is the peculiar work of the diaphragm? Diaphragm means a sheet of tissue which separates thorax from abdomen. But what is the real work of the diaphragm? Helps in pressure gradient, increase and decrease, increase and decrease. So major work of the diaphragm helps in pressure gradient. The pressure, it denotes what we see, maybe the increase or maybe the decrease. The two work done by what we say the diaphragm. See, I will tell you very important one. Inspiration occurs, pressure inside the lung, very important, inside the lungs, less than atmospheric pressure, very 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 important, less than atmospheric pressure. Expiration occurs, pressure within the lungs, within the lungs, higher than the atmospheric pressure. See, there may be very important one. Inspiration occurs, pressure inside the lungs less than atmospheric pressure. Expiration occurs within the lungs higher than the atmospheric pressure. Kindly listen, what are the muscles participating breathing? One is called internal intercostal muscles, external intercostal muscles, both found between ribs. Diaphragm helps in pressure gradient increase or decrease. Inspiration occurs, pressure inside the lungs less than atmospheric pressure. Expiration occurs, pressure within the lungs higher than the atmospheric pressure. Inspiration less than atmospheric pressure, expiration higher than the atmospheric pressure. See, listen, we have seen now what are the muscles participating. See, there may be many questions they may go and be asked. Difference between inspiration and expiration. And the lungs do not contain muscle fiber. Lungs cover double wall membrane part. Lungs expand contract by movement of what we say ribs and diaphragm. What is diaphragm? A sheet of tissue which separates thorax from abdomen. In relaxed diaphragm, it seems to be what shaped, we may say dome shape. What we say, it is called as what we say dome shape. We may say muscles participating breathing, internal intercostal muscle, external intercostal muscle, and the diaphragm. See, we will see about the inspiration detail. Inspiration, trachea. Okay, it is called atmospheric air inhaled, O2. Okay. Now it reaches into interior. Okay.
It initiated contraction of diaphragm.
Okay.
External intercostal muscle. Okay. And sternum. It is situated here. So, inspiration initiated contraction of three parts, diaphragm muscles, external intercostal muscle. Inspiration, external intercostal muscles, and sternum. Upwards and outwards. See, what are the area will going to be expanded, listen. Upward and outward. See here, it is upward. They are called as, it is upward. They are called as what we see outward. Increase the volume of thoracic chamber. Lungs expand. Why? Because air is inhaled. Air is, atmospheric air is inhaled at a time. Lungs automatically expand. Increase the pulmonary volume, lung volume. Decrease the intrapulmonary pressure. Very important one. See, increase the pulmonary volume in inspiration, but decrease intrapulmonary pressure. Forces fresh air outside to enter there. See, the aeromorphism outside. And also passage to the lungs, and also it equalizes the pressure. See, these are all going to be equalized the pressure. See, kind attention, inspiration initiated contraction of diaphragm, external intercostal muscle, and sternum. Upward, outward, increase the volume of the thoracic chamber, lungs expand, increase pulmonary volume, decrease intrapulmonary pressure, forces fresh air outside to enter the passage to the lungs. At a time, it will going to be equalized the pressure. See, in the inspiration, the three important mechanism will going to be happened. It is active process, air inhaled, rib cage expand. Very, very important one. Inspiration is active process, air inhaled, rib cage expand. 1 minute, increase pulmonary volume, decrease intrapulmonary pressure. Opposite, what is expiration? See, what is expiration? We want to know that. What is expiration? See here. Listen. Relaxation of diaphragm. It is going to be relaxed. Allows the diaphragm and the sternum return into dome shape. Internal intercostal muscle contract. Listen here, external intercostal muscle contract, but expiration, internal intercostal muscle contract, pulling the ribs downward. Why? Because it is air is going out. So, reducing the thoracic volume and pulmonary volume. Very easy one. If you understand about these inspiration, all opposite points of that what we say expiration. Relaxation of diaphragm allows the diaphragm and the sternum to return dome shape, world shape. Internal intercostal muscle contract, pulling the ribs downward. Reducing the thoracic volume and the pulmonary volume. Very important one. Reducing the thoracic volume and the pulmonary volume. Above all results, these all process increase intrapulmonary pressure. Yes. Why? Because air is blown out. At a time, increase intrapulmonary pressure. Slightly above the atmospheric pressure. That should be very important. These are all, there may be a chance, it may be, they may go to be asked in neat questions also. While the statement questions also, they may go to be asked. In expiration, increase intrapulmonary pressure, slightly above the atmospheric pressure, results expulsion of air from lungs. That's called expiration. Results expulsion of air from lungs. Here,
Inspiration, active process. It is passive process. Air is inhaled, air is exhaled. Rib cage expand, rib cage gets small. You want to know these evident parts. Parts remember, inspiration, active process. Expiration, passive process. Inspiration, air is inhaled. Expiration, air exhaled. Rib cage expand here, the rib cage gets small. Inspiration, external intercostal muscles are participating. But expiration, internal intercostal muscles are participating. Active, passive. Air inhaled, air exhaled. Rib cage expand, rib cage gets small. On an average healthy human breathes 12 to 16 times per minute. Pakka one word. 12 to 16 times per minute. On an average healthy human breathes 12 to 16 times per minute. See, there is a device to assess about the lungs. They are called, what we say, spirometer. What we are going to be called? Spirometer. What is the natural work of the spirometer? It is the instrument used to measure volume of the air. How much is interior? How much is goes out? Used to clinical assessment. Is there any deformities? Or is there any damage? Or is there any default in the lung? It will going to be identify very clearly by the help of the device called, what we say, spirometer. Spirometer is an electronic device or instrument used to measure the volume of the air breathing at the time of breathing, and used to assess the clinical assessment, whether it is normal, whether it is abnormal, whether it is any damage or maybe the problem, it will going to be guided to by the help of, what we say, spirometer. Dears, see, what is our topic? Mechanism of breathing or ventilation. See, for example, what is called breathing, okay, and what is called inspiration and expiration. What are the muscles participating in the breathing? And also, what you want to be know, what are the events takes place? Inspiration and expiration. And also, where it is active, where it is passive. And also, we want to be know, where that, what we say, less than atmospheric pressure, or higher than atmospheric pressure, we want to be know. And also, seventh one, on average, my healthy man breathes how many times, we want to be know. And write something about, what we say, spirometer, we want to be know that. If you know all these, that is concluded as, what we say, mechanism of, what we say, breathing. It is called as, what we say, mechanism of breathing. So please listen, I will draw a simple diagram here. How to draw that, what we say, the diagram of, what we say, which one, that lungs. See, please listen. See, for example, we want to be know, yes, it is called as, what we say, the trachea covered by C-shaped cartilages. It will going to be protect that, what we say, the cartilage. And also it divides into two branches. They are namely, what we say, bronchi. See here, lungs covered by double-walled membrane. Yes, it divides into, what we say, many one. Okay, what are the parts? It is called as, what we say, trachea. Okay, it is called as, what we say, bronchi. It is called as, what we say, bronchioles. And also it is called as, what we say, air sacs. Air sacs.
It is called as what we see plural. It is they are called as what we see plural membrane, pleura. It is called as what we see pleural fluid, and also they are called air sacs. And also what we could be say, it is covered by what we say that what we say rib cage. Yes, yes. They are called as what we say the diaphragm. They may going to be asked. Draw and label the respiratory system or lungs diagram. It is a very important one. There may be many 2-mark questions are there, 3-mark is there, 5-mark is there, neat questions are there. I told everything. You have watched nicely. Okay, go through today. You read your syllabus, mechanism of breathing thoroughly, and reply your answer through our class, next class. Thank you.